Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I want to show you how you can use formulas in Microsoft Excel. And as full disclosure, before we jump into this, I work at Microsoft as a full-time employee. All right, well, let's jump into it. Here I am in Microsoft Excel. This is the latest version. I have Office 365, but these same formulas should work on any older versions of Excel as well, whether you have 2019, 2016, 2013, 2007, you name the version, it'll probably work. So here I am in Microsoft Excel, and I have a list of formulas that I want to show you how you can use them in Excel. If there's one that interests you more than others, feel free to jump to that section of the video. I have timestamps down below in the comments, and you can just jump to the section that you find interesting. So how do you do Excel or formulas in Excel? So we're gonna start with the basics of add, subtract, multiply, and divide. So let's say that I have two numbers in cells. I have one and one, and I wanna add these up. How do I do that? Well, the key to doing formulas in Excel is you always start with the equal sign. So here I'm gonna enter equal, and what I could do is I could say, well, what is 1 plus 1? So I could just enter that in, and you'll see that shows up in this formula bar up above. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna hit enter, and you'll see that it added those two values up. So it says equals 1 plus 1. Now what I can also do is instead of typing the numbers into that formula bar, I could use numbers that are on my spreadsheet. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. And once again, we're gonna start with the equal sign. And instead I'm gonna say, hey, this value here that's in cell B1, let's take that and I wanna add it to the value that's here in cell C1, and so I did the plus sign and then C1, and so here you see it says B1 plus C1. So it's taking those two cells, and now I'm gonna hit enter, and so it added those two up. And now I'm gonna show a few examples, subtract, multiply, divide, that you do them all the same way as addition. So let's say I wanna do 2 minus 1. What I'll do is I'll do equals, we could do 2 minus 1 and hit enter, and that'll tell us it's one. But once again, I wanna use the cells. So we're gonna do cell B2, and we're gonna subtract cell C2. And then I'm gonna hit enter, and what do you know? 2 minus 1 is 1. Big news flash there. And now we're gonna do a few other examples. We're gonna do 2 times 2, and then we'll do 4 divided by 2. So let's do 2 times 2. So once again, we're gonna enter the equal sign, and we're gonna take cell B3, and then multiply. You can't enter an X here like the multiplication sign. Instead, what we're gonna do is we enter the asterisk sign. And then we're gonna multiply that by cell C3. You don't have to enter, you could also enter the cell values, or you could just click with your mouse. Clicking with the mouse is easier, so why don't we do that? So I'm gonna click that, and 2 times 2 is 4. And here, same with division, I'm gonna do 4, and then we're gonna see how many times 2 goes into 4. The division sign on the computer is the forward slash, so I'm gonna enter the forward slash, and then we're gonna click on cell C4, and so we're gonna do B4 divided by C4, and what is 4 divided by 2, everyone? It is 2. 2 goes into 4 two times. So add, subtract, multiply, divide, those are all pretty straightforward. Now let's say a little more difficult. Let's say that I wanted to add all these values up. Now once again, you could enter a formula where you say, okay, well 1 plus 1 plus 2. It's going to take a long time. We have a lot of different cells, so we don't want to do that. I could also say, this plus this, plus this, plus this, but that also is gonna take a long time, and we don't wanna do that. So that's where the sum formula comes in. It makes things a little bit easier for us, and what you could do is you do equals again, and then we type in sum, and then I'm gonna do open parentheses, and then here it's giving you a little hint of what you need to do, so number 1, number 2. So here I could go in, and I could say, this one, and then it says insert a comma, so comma, comma. So I could do that, but that's still not that good, so we're gonna go to equals sum and then open parentheses, and then I could just highlight all these numbers. So I'm just clicking with my mouse and dragging it, and then I'm gonna close the parentheses at the end, and I hit enter, and that adds up all the values. It's 24, so super easy to do. What I could also do is I could click on this formula sign, and I could say sum, and if you want help writing your formula, so here too you could see kind of how it's done, but here I could drag all the numbers in that I wanna sum, and then I could click OK. So if you'd rather not kind of deal with opening and shutting your parentheses, that's another way you could do it. But here you see that the value is 24, and we're good there. Some of the other things I could do, min, that gives me the minimum value above. So here are all these values. Just by glancing at it, you could see that the minimum value I have here is 1. But what I could do is I could just type in min, And then we're gonna open my parentheses. I'm gonna highlight all my numbers that I want a min for, and then I'm gonna close my parentheses. So you tend to do that a lot when you enter a formula. You have a parentheses open and a parentheses close. I'm gonna enter that. The minimum value there is 1. We could see what the max is. So here I'm gonna highlight all these same numbers and then close the parentheses, and the max value that I have here is 4. If I now were to change this to 10, you'll see that this automatically updates to 10. Similarly, if I were to change that to 0, that would automatically say the minimum value is now 0. Okay, now we want to look at counts. And so what count does is you can basically count all the cells that have a number in them. So what I'll do is I'll say, let's count. And I want to know in this, so in this set, let's say these set, this set of numbers, how many cells are there that have a number? So I highlighted all those. I'm going to close the parentheses again, and I'm going to hit enter. And so it says there are 12 numbers. Well, that makes sense because 1, 2, 3, 4, and then another 4, and then another 4 gives me 12. What's interesting is it only looks for cells that have a number in it. So, you know, here I could go and I could highlight all these, close the parentheses. It's still only telling me 12 because all these other cells that I copied have no value in it. Now, there's also called something called count A, and that counts all the cells that even just have a value in them. So we'll go equals again, count A, and then I'm going to highlight, let's highlight all these cells, and then I'll close it. There too, there are 12. But let's say I type in my name here. So it's counting any cell that has a value. So that counts Kevin, but the count formula is only counting cells with numbers. And so that's why I didn't pick up the Kevin. And then here I could type in another value. Let's say I type in the city I live in, Seattle. And so you see the count A is picking up that cell. All right, so moving on down here, we want to know the average now. So we're going to change it up a little bit. I'm going to type in, let's type in some salaries. Let's say that these are different income levels. And then I'm just going to throw on the dollar sign so they actually look like dollar amounts. And so let's say I want to know the average income. I just type in average, super easy. The name of the formula matches what you're trying to do. And then I'll just highlight those incomes. And then so the average is 42,500. You'll notice that the 100,000 is pulling the average up. And then you could also do the median. The median is the middlemost value. So you take all your values, you line them up. What is the value in the middle? So here I'm going to select these values and we're going to see what the median is. It looks like the median, it said 27.5. If I threw in, let's say, another value, let's extend that one more, then it'll pick the middlemost value. So there's 30,000. One thing you'll notice is the average is just an average across all the numbers. The median is the middlemost value, so the median is lower than the average. What I could also do, concatenate. So my name is Kevin Stratvert, and let's say I wanted to concatenate them. Concatenate basically means taking one and connecting it to another. So I could say concat, and I'll take this value, and then we're going to enter a comma. It's telling me to put a comma there between the values, and then I'll close the parentheses, and there it's filled it in. Although I might want, let's say I want to add a space in there, so I'm going to add a space in that cell. You could concatenate as many values as you want. So here I could also bring in that value, and that brought in the space. So that's concatenate. If is pretty nice. This is bringing logic into Excel. So what I'm going to do is, let's say this is smile. So what I could say is if, and what I want to do is if, let's say this cell equals smile, then what I want to do is I want to say yay. And if it doesn't, so the value of true and the value of false. So if it's not true and it doesn't contain that, then I'm going to say boo. And so here it's smile, so it says yay. And let's say it's frown, then it says boo. So there you can see how you can include an if statement to basically say, you know, if this cell contains something, do this or that. I can also count if. So this is kind of interesting. What I could do is, so let's say count if, and I could say, you know, of this range, so I'll say I want to count, let's say here, I want to count the number of cells that have a 10 in it. Okay, so basically you say, hey, this is my range, and then what's my criteria? The criteria is what I'm looking for, and so I'm looking for a 10. And here it tells me within this range, only one cell has a 10 in it, so it tells me 1. A few others, and these are getting more advanced as we go on, Vlookup. So I'm going to show a quick example here. I'm going to type in a few names, And we're gonna put down our favorite colors. So I like red, which is why I'm wearing this red shirt. And Alex likes blue and Steven likes yellow. So with VLOOKUP, what I could say is I wanna look across these values and I wanna return back this other column. So let's show a quick example. I also have a video on VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP that goes more in depth if you want a deeper example. So I could say I wanna look up Kevin. So you read the lookup value and then table array, that's just the table that I'm looking in. So I'm gonna do a comma. This is the table that I'm looking at. So I'm gonna highlight that table and I wanna get the color back. It says column index number. Well, that's the column that I wanna get back. So I'm gonna say, well, the second column. And then the last thing is, do I want an exact approximate match or exact match? What that means is, you know, if my name was Kevin something, an approximate match would match, but I wanna do an exact match. So I'll just click on that. And then we'll close parentheses. And so here it returns Kevin's favorite color is red. So it looks for the value here and then it returns the value here. That's what I could do with VLOOKUP. Okay, with SUMIF, what I wanna do is let's say that we have these numbers associated with these different people and I only wanna add up the number when it's associated with Kevin. What I could do is we'll do SUMIF and I wanna look at this range. And the criteria I want to look for is that it's Kevin, and then this is my sum range that I'm looking at. And so what this does is it says, hey, you know, we have two Kevins, and the value associated with them is 10 and then 5, and it sums them. So let's take a look at that again. So here is, so if I go through the formula again, sum if, I want to know the range, that's my range. The criteria is that it equals Kevin, and then I want to add up these values every time there's a Kevin. And so there are two here, a 10 and a 5, and so I'll hit enter, and so it's 15. So that's doing SUMIF. And then the last one, super simple to finish off with. If I wanna know the current time, I just do equals now, and then open and close parentheses, and that tells me the exact time. Today's July 12th, 2019, 1:18 in the afternoon, Pacific Standard Time. That's when I created this video, and that's when we're finishing the video. But that's just a very quick tutorial of how you can enter formulas and how you could use formulas in Excel. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see future videos like this, hit that subscribe button. That way you'll get a notification anytime new content like this comes out. And if you want to see more videos, more tutorials, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you're looking for and I'll add it to my list of videos to make. All right, well, I'll see you next time. Thanks a lot and bye.